Ladies and gentlemen, this makes Watergate look like a fourth-rate burglary.
Oh my goodness. The deep state is so much in our face, and we're supposed to act like it's not even happening. You still have people on the left acting like it's not real. When the FBI showed up at Roger Stone's house 6 a.m. in the morning with an exclusive with CNN covering it all, is a clear indication that the FBI is working with the liberal media.
This is exclusive CNN video. This is what happened this morning before sunrise, just before 6 a.m., when Roger Stone, longtime Trump associate and advisor, was taken into custody by the FBI. There's a moment of audio on here that I want to play for everyone, because this is what the first sounds that Roger Stone woke up to this morning was: the FBI pounding on his door and shouting this. I want to just play this for a moment.
How come they didn't call InfoWars to cover it? How come they didn't call Breitbart to cover it? How come they didn't call Fox News to cover it? How come they didn't give any of these conservative media outlets the exclusive on this?
Joining us now is CNN producer David Shortell. He was on the scene when this happened in Fort Lauderdale. Tell us everything that transpired this morning.
Allison, an extraordinary morning. We were here at 5 a.m. waiting for whatever was going to happen. It was dark, 6 a.m., just after the hour. About a half dozen police vehicles with sirens, but no sound. Silent sirens pull in front of this Fort Lauderdale home where Roger Stone was presumably asleep. The lights were off in the house. About a dozen officers, FBI agents wearing tactical vests and with large weapons, fanned out across his front lawn.
What? What? He was there at 5 a.m. waiting on the FBI to raid Roger Stone's home? How much more do you need to see? We are beyond waiting for the Civil War to take place. We are in it right now. This is clear. This is completely clear what is happening here, people. This is beyond what everyone is expecting to happen in this nation. Never before have we seen anything like this, with the FBI working directly with the liberal media outlet. He just said it.
Now, I think a lot of you know that for the last several months, I have been the subject of an extraordinary Gestapo-like witch hunt by the illegitimate special counsel Robert Mueller.
We are seeing the deep state in full effect. The liberal media is complicit with working with the FBI to take down conservatives.
Our video exclusively you saw shot by Gil De La Rosa, an extraordinary arrest here in Fort Lauderdale this morning.
And do you remember this picture when the liberal media was trying to say that he was racist because he had a smirk on his face? Look at the smirk on this CNN reporter or the CNN producer as he's happy to talk about what took place.
What was Roger Stone's reaction? Did you watch them take him into custody?
That smirk on his face proves that they are excited every single time they think they're that much closer on taking out the president of the United States. Roger Stone lays it out in this video exactly why they are attacking him.
So when it comes to the phony dossier and the illegal and unconstitutional use of the FISA law to spy on Donald Trump's campaign on the basis of fabricated evidence of Russian collusion, there's a simple question. What did Barack Obama know, and when did he know it?
The objective here is to get anyone that is close to President Trump to try to squeeze them, to try to squeeze any information out of them, be it true or false, just to go after President Trump.
What they do traditionally is to try to fabricate some crime on your part, and then use that to squeeze you to bear false witness against a bigger fish. Well, Donald Trump is the biggest fish there is. Let me just say this. Michael Cohen, I am not.
Everything that they're doing here is personal. Listen to what Roger Stone says about Mueller.
In the anthrax matter, Mr. Mueller arrested the wrong three men, and then the man he did arrest died mysteriously in captivity of a Tylenol overdose. Mr. Mueller let four men rot in a Boston jail that he knew they were convicted of a murder they didn't commit in order to cover up mob FBI informants. Mr. Mueller led the cover-up in BCCI. Mr. Mueller led the cover-up of Lockerbie 103. Seems to me that Bobby Three Sticks is not exactly the white knight they tell us he is. And now, in the case of me, I can tell you, they have no evidence of Russian collusion. They have no evidence of WikiLeaks collaboration. And they have no evidence whatsoever that I had any advanced knowledge of the acquisition and publication of John Podesta's incredibly incriminating and embarrassing emails.
The whole Russia thing is a setup from the get-go, and Roger Stone has been laying it out there, and they want to shut him up. Even when he went to his press conference after he came out of the courtroom, the media was yelling, lock him up. The media was yelling, trying to prevent him from having his voice. And that's exactly what the FBI is doing here. The FBI is trying to shut him up from saying anything.
The charges today relate in no way to Russian collusion, WikiLeaks collaboration, or any other illegal act in connection with the 2016 campaign.
But today could be the day that I am framed.
He straight up said, tomorrow's news, next year's news, today.
The underlying rationale for surveillance on the Republican candidate for president. Let's think about this for a moment. This is an abuse of power in which the authority and capability of the state was used to try to rig the 2016 election. Now, in all honesty, they seek to destroy me financially. You see, I was sued by a left-wing group here in D.C. that tells, and here's why they sued me. They said that the Russians hacked the DNC. They gave the information to Julian Assange of WikiLeaks. Assange gave it to Roger Stone, and he gave it to Donald Trump. That is nonsense. In fact, I question whether the DNC was hacked by anybody.
They never talk about Seth Rich. Seth Rich used to work at the DNC. And what, weeks later, after the emails from John Podesta reached WikiLeaks, then Seth Rich all of a sudden died in the streets?
The forensic evidence shows the contrary, shows that the material that was so very embarrassing to the Democrats, because Hillary had to cheat poor Bernie Sanders. She couldn't beat an 82-year-old socialist for the Democratic nomination without cheating. So the whole question of where this information came from is meant to be a distraction from the content of the information. Because if you read the WikiLeaks disclosures, you'll find that Hillary herself was up to her hips in their dirty tricks operation to foment violence at the Donald Trump rallies. Bill and Hillary Clinton are the penicillin-resistant syphilis of the American body politic.
How much more of this can the country take? How much more before everything just implodes? Who's to stop the FBI from going after innocent people? Who's to stop the FBI from working with the liberal media? Who's to stop the FBI from doing the bidding of the deep state? Who's to stop the FBI from taking out the president of the United States of America? My name is Will Johnson, West Coast correspondent for Infowars.com. Hello. Infowars is under sustained massive attack like no other network has before in the history of this country. Go to Infowars.com and Newswars.com and share the articles. That is the best way to join this fight. And for the latest live videos, go to Infowars.com/show. Help us in this mission. To launch the new renaissance, go to Infowarsstore.com. And if you're on an Android device, go download the Infowars app today for free. Remember, we are listener supported. We don't get billions of dollars from the government. We don't get billions of dollars from Silicon Valley or George Soros with NGOs. Check out the highest quality nutraceuticals and supplements at InfowarsStore.com. Join us in this fight. We need your help. Thank you, and God bless.
InfoWars, tomorrow's news, today. When it comes to rebuilding your energy, convenience is key. While coffee, candy, and other sugary products can give you a short boost, the crash can leave you more tired than ever. Turbo Force from InfoWars Life is a powerful mix-in energy packet that utilizes vitamins, amino acids, and extracts used for hundreds of years to provide you focus, clarity, and a boost of energy on the go. Simply take a packet, mix it into the indicated amount of water, and enjoy. With 14 servings per box for a 2-week or more supply, this is the formula to stock up on whenever you need a boost. Perfect for work, in the car, or at home, Turbo Force is the ultimate answer to a sluggish day. Don't let your day slow you down. Perk up with Turbo Force at InfoWarsStore.com